da. Ba 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 ba. Good evening to you, VW. How are you doing, VW? Pam 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 para pam pam. Hallelujah. Hello, Claptrap. Pam 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 bara pam pam bara pam.
So, see, Chan's patrol is making progress.
Yes.
Excellent.
Yes.
I'm glad to hear our men are handling things.
Yes, of course. Your men are very good at handling things. Congrats to your men and yourself for staying there, sitting in that spot and doing nothing. Congrats to you. Dun, dun. How am I? I am good. VW, I am good. I thought I should make a surprise today and do a live stream of me and my daughter. My daughter is this build here. This is how I call it, my daughter build. And here we are, playing Titan Quest again. Param 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 param. Claptrap, how are you doing? Is everything okay, Claptrap? Oh, what the... Whew, almost. Almost. They almost killed me. Dragonian mages. Yeah, my resistances are not the best, so... I'm going to be having problems here. My cold resistance is very bad. Lightning is okay, just okay. Fire is just okay. Pierce is perfect. Perfecto. Pierce resistance. Vitality is almost perfect. No problems here. Only poison is my worst resistance, and of course, bleeding. And I have 0% physical, but physical is added physical resistance to armor. It comes in addition to armor. And yeah, this is not a negative number, even though my armor here is not the best again. This item, for example, doesn't have the best base armor. The same applies to this one, to this one. This one has a good, very good base armor, but it is not enough. Everything is fine. Hello, Doza! You have a lot of bananas here. Doza, you are very lucky. I wouldn't say no to some bananas now, but I don't have any bananas now. Hello, Elias Cusis. Hello, son. Very good today's stream. Yeah. We have a small surprise. Today, this stream is a small surprise. Pam pam para pam pam para pam param pam param pam pam para pam pam para pam param pam 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 para pam pam para pam param pam param. Is it more important to have a big armor value or high resistance? Well, you see, armor helps against physical damage. The rest of the resistances help against the other types of damage. Everything is very important in Legendary. But, you know, physical damage is almost everywhere in the game. It is one of the most common types of damage in the game. So, you need armor, and if you don't have good armor, at least you need good physical resistance, this resistance here. Now, between these two, armor or physical resistance, you go with this one. This is you want to have this one. If you have this one, everything is fine. This comes in addition, and I say this because physical resistance, this one we get mostly from some items, not many items. There are some items that provide physical resistance, and it is not easy to stack lots of physical resistance for most of the builds. So this is more important for you. This is very important. This is more important than this one, for example, when you play with mage classes. And with mage classes, you cannot have a very good armor here. So, if you can find some items to stack physical resistance in addition to this armor for mage classes, yeah, this would be the best. I don't know why the people complain about Diablo 4 graphics. Diablo 4 graphics look very nice. They look what they should be for a Diablo game, I don't know. At least in dungeons. Now outside, maybe they can... they can fix them a little bit for outside.
These are dangerous, you see. They're this trinket. This trinket.
This trinket. This trinket.
You come to us on an auspicious day. Please, see what we have to offer. Safe travels.
Yeah, sure. Nobody can travel safely in this world of monsters, baby dinosaurs, and whatnot. Where is my coffee? Because I need to drink coffee. I need to wake up. The weather is very strange today. It was raining before, now it is not raining, but... you know, it is that time of the year where the weather is very strange and it makes you feel very sleepy or bored and things like that. I'm not bored, but I feel a bit sleepy. Grim Dawn has better graphics than Diablo 4. No, I wouldn't say that. No, for a Diablo game, no, it doesn't. They compare Skyrim to Diablo 4 graphics, I don't get it. What? Well, actually, Skyrim, I guess they compare the art style of Skyrim. Skyrim has a very, I could say, gothic-like art style. It is awesome. The art style of Skyrim is awesome because it is very realistic, you could say. And maybe this is why they compare it. And okay, if we make this comparison, yeah, Skyrim probably has more better art style for a Diablo-themed game than what we saw in the Diablo 4 trailer and demo. Not trailer, in the demo. The cinematic was awesome, but it was not gameplay. So here we are again with my 13 plus 1 types of damage build. It is not really 13 types of damage, it is 14 types of damage. And maybe it is 15 types of damage, but I have missed the 15th type. I'm not sure, I don't know. Let's go down here, there is a cave. Da-da-dun. Da-da-da-dun-dun. Hello, Captain. Привет, Vladimir. Maybe. Lilith is the final boss. Doza, nobody knows. Nobody knows what is going to be the role of Lilith. If it is going to be the final boss or something else. We also don't know if Diablo will come back at some point in this Diablo 4 game. Maybe we will fight him again somehow. But not as a final boss, maybe in another form. Who knows? Maybe the developers will transform all of the primevals to humans. Humans possessed by the primevals, then in this game, Diablo 4, we have to search for all of these 7 and fight against all of the 7. 7 different bosses, 7 primevals, I think, if I remember correctly. I don't remember exactly the story, the lore of Diablo. I think it is... it is... 3 primevals at 4 lesser evils, or is it... It shouldn't be 7 primevals, it should be 3, I think. Anyway, I don't remember. But, yeah, what if they will bring all of the primevals in Diablo 4 as bosses, and the story will have them now in human form. They are humans, and when you fight them, the first phase of the boss fight is the human form, and then when you destroy the first phase of the boss, in the second phase it becomes, you know, a demon. Diablo becomes Diablo, and you fight Diablo again. Something like that. Is that a free stream? Vanetric, what free stream? This is a surprise stream. Do you start playing all of your characters from level 1? No, not anymore. I play from level 40. Because playing from level 40, it saves me time to make more builds. And I can make play more builds. Ήχτι ανεγείς. Ήχτι ανεγείς. Να πάω να γαμήθεις. What is this? Buy me a chocolate, Captain. If anybody would like to buy me a chocolate, since we cannot do it in the real world, they can donate $1, and I would be able to buy a chocolate. This is what it is. It is a donation goal. You made an extra stream. Vanetric, yeah, it is an extra stream. This is why I call it a surprise stream, because it is not in my schedule. So, yes. And I will try to make as many extra streams as possible these days. Why? May ask why? Because I guess you would like me to do that. This is why. Even though I have to work on my other new videos of builds for Titan Quest and things like that. By the way, how is the volume of the game? Is it too high? Do you want me to reduce it?
Da-da-da.
Why did you say forgive me? I fear I may have been a warrior. Your example has taught me.
Socrates Ichthyon crown. Okay. I don't need this item. But it is a good item to sell. Ta-da-da. Mr. Klakos, all good? All good? Are you doing good, Mr. Klakos? It is fine compared to your voice. Ah, okay. Mr. Klakos, do you mean the volume is all good? Okay. $190,000 experience. This sound effect when I cast this skill, this sound effect comes from the soul drain. This sound effect is very, it feels like it comes from the other world. It is from another world, and it is also, it is very dark, very Diablo-like, Diablo 4-like, or maybe I should say just Diablo-like. It is a scary one. One day in the future, it is in my plans to make a necromancer built in Titan Quest. How will I make it? I will find a way and I will make it in necromancer build. Do you play online PvP games sometimes? PvP games? Do you mean something like League of Legends or Dota? No, no. I was playing Medal of Honor at Battlefield multiplayer, years ago. 7-8 years ago, I don't remember. A team deathmatch, things like that, not PvP. A team deathmatch is PvP, but it is team PvP, it is not one versus one. But anyway, yeah, I was playing these games back in the day, now no. I haven't played such a game FPS online multiplayer for a long time. And if I try to play now such a game, my opponents will kick my butt very hard. I will need to practice very much before I can play efficiently again such games. But I don't have any plans doing that. I don't care about PvP. Alien? What is next to the alien sun? You got some candy? It is a puzzle. Do you know from what movie this text is? No. I will tell you that this child is talking to something and that something corresponds with the same. I know. No, son, I don't know. Hello, Lalus. Hello, Balance. Already knows the world and everything about Diablo 4. Cool. Vanedric, I wish I knew. Actually, I don't wish I knew about the world, but I... Yeah, I wish nothing about Diablo 4. The only thing that I wish is... I don't know... For Diablo 4 to come out to release as soon as possible. I mean, I don't want to wait until the March of 2023 for the release of Diablo 4, because this is when it will be released. Diablo 4 comes out at the first quarter, around March or February of 2023. How do I know this? I don't know this, I'm just saying. I know nothing. I am the true Jon Snow, the one that knows nothing. Vanetric, you got me to teach you about Diablo 4. Hello, Mockingbird. Predator 2. What? Predator 2. Hello, Albuddy. I think they will develop this game for about 2 to 5 years. 2.5. I don't know, Lalos. I don't know. But we will have to wait a long time and it's going to be painful. But I mean, it is okay if you think about it, because we have other games to play with and other new games are coming as well. For example, this January, we are waiting for Wolsen to be released. Even though I feel like the Wolsen will get pushed back for a couple of months and it will come out maybe March of 2020. But the goal of the developers is for January 2020. Let's hope they can make it happen. 2 months from now. 2 months. Only 2 months from today. Next year we will also get... We will have the release of Last Epoch. I think before the end of 2019 we are waiting for Torchlight Frontiers to release. But I don't know if this game is going to be good. It is a super cartoony game and I don't know as an MMO game if it will be a good Torchlight game or not. But anyway, at least we have Wolsen to look forward to. And we will see what happens. But Wolsen, I plan on spending many hours on Wolsen because I like the game so far. What was that? Give me a sec. Brevius Titan. And also Mr. Clackos. Thank you for the follow, guys. Welcome. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, everything works. Nice. Hello, Lazar. I have recently purchased Ragnarok expansion. What about Atlantis? Is it worth? Lazar, Atlantis is worth it 100%. Totally, yes, totally worth it. Atlantis is totally worth it. That about the Diablo 4 release that you came up with is probably possible. Yeah, Vanetric, I feel like it will come at 2023, the first quarter of 2023. This is what Diablo told me. You have to realize that it is like the last chance for Diablo to become an actual game. You still have Diablo 2 Remaster coming, so that might be decent. Ah, yeah, Vanetric, I totally forgot about Diablo 2. So, if Diablo 2 comes out... Yeah, but when? I mean... it is 100% sure that they are working currently on Diablo 2 Remaster. Absolutely certain. But in this BlizzCon, they said nothing about Diablo 2. But you know, they can reveal Diablo 2 Remastered, maybe not in a BlizzCon or something like that. They can, one day, they can write in their Twitter or their Diablo 3 page, they can make a blog post, something like that, and say that Diablo 2 Remastered is coming and we will reveal more information in the near future, stay tuned, you know, all of these things. They could do that. Thank you. So we will have to wait and see when Diablo 2 remastered will come out, and we will see. Let's hope it will come out before the end of next year, 2020, so we have something new Diablo new to play with until Diablo 4. Of course, some people would say that we have something Diablo new coming before Diablo 4, it is Diablo Immortal. Yes, but it is better to have also a game to play on your PC and not on your tiny little screen of your phone. Wait, what happens? What is that? La luz. La luz. La luz, you got some new emotes. La luz, thank you very much for becoming a member on the channel. Welcome, La luz. Thank you. Awesome. One more member for the X line of Epic Heroes, we could say. It is still the line of Epic Heroes, La luz. You are still in the line of Epic Heroes, but now we have a new name, Mr. Phi, but it is the same thing. Welcome, thank you very much, La luz. I'm missing the chat, guys. Stupid Blizzard already revealed the Necromancer by accident. Guess I'll play. Wait, Albadi, what do you mean? The Necromancer by accident, do you mean on Diablo 4? I know nothing about this thing. Albadi, are you referring to Diablo 4? Let them have the time to make Diablo 4, I will wait for it, and when it comes, I want it to be the Diablo we all want. Yeah, this is true, Lalus, yeah. They should take their time and make truly a great Diablo game. They should... I will say something that I would like to say for Titan Quest more, because Titan Quest is my favorite game. But I cannot say it for Titan Quest because we don't have a Titan Quest announcement. We know nothing about a Titan Quest 2 game coming out in the future. This is just our wishful thinking. But anyway, but what I will say about Diablo 4 is that I would like to see Diablo 4 becoming going up to the throne of action RPG games again, because in the past it was Diablo 2. In the action RPG genre, Diablo 2 was the king of the genre. And I would like to see, if not Titan Quest, then Diablo 4 to become the king again. And I'm not talking about sales of the game, because, you know, I mean, when it comes to sales of the game, Diablo 3 is already the king. Diablo 3 has made so many billions of dollars to the company, to Blizzard, that Diablo 3 is the king when it comes to financials. Path of Exile does not even come close to Diablo 3 when it comes to sales, but we are not talking about sales here, we are talking about the essence of the game, what truly matters. Diablo 2 Remastered revealed on December. That's what I hope. Albadi, yeah, why not? They did come out with the Warcraft remaster completely randomly. Yeah, Vanetric. They could reveal it maybe after January, February, March, something like that. They don't need a BlizzCon to reveal Diablo 2 remaster. After all, you know, we all know that it is coming because they made an official post in their website of Diablo, the job postings, where they post job positions for new people to go and work with Blizzard. They made the post one day in the past, 1 or 2 years ago, I don't remember when, and they said that we are restoring StarCraft 1, Warcraft 3, and Diablo 2 back to glory. And so far they have made a remaster of StarCraft 1, a remaster of Warcraft 3. There is only Diablo 2 left to remaster. So it is coming. It is officially coming. So, and this is why they don't really need a BlizzCon to announce it. Maybe they will announce it. I rather have a Diablo 2 remake instead of a remaster. If it is a remaster, we will get some bug fixes, better MP support, and higher res sprites. Yeah, Mockingbird, but I don't see them making a remake. Hello, Puya! What is that? Buy me a chocolate! Whoever wants to buy me a chocolate, they can donate 1 euro so I can buy a chocolate. Diablo 4 will not have offline play, but only online play. Yeah, this is also... okay, look, guys, that was to be expected. I mean, after Diablo 3, 7 years ago, Diablo 3 came out 7 years ago, and we knew since then that, okay, from now on, Diablo games will be always online only. I never expect to get an offline game anymore. Only Diablo 2 Remaster will be offline, single player, but... And how can they make Diablo 4 offline single player when the world of the game is an MMO-like world? They have an open world game. It is MMO-like, and it will never become offline. I don't think so. Is Titan Quest still being supported at Walkton? I mean, the further parts expansion are to expand. Lazar, absolutely yes. Absolutely yes. I feel that we have seen nothing yet when it comes to Titan Quest. Remember this. Remember this thing. We have seen nothing. We are expecting Titan Quest, a big patch which will fix, hopefully, many problems of multiplayer, and also it will improve performance of the game. We expect patch which in the future which will bring controller support for PC. That many a big part of the community of PC asks for controller support. We have DLCs Ragnarok and Atlantis coming to consoles, and after all of these things happen, maybe next year we will get an announcement of something new for Titan Quest. But I am super optimistic about Titan Quest. I think that we have seen nothing yet. More patches are coming though. And more features will come in the future, I think. Were you always streaming on YouTube and Twitch at the same time? Lalus? Lalus, I started streaming in general, I think it was around February or January of 2018. I started streaming on YouTube only. Then some people wanted me to stream on Twitch, but it didn't make sense to me to go on Twitch because, you know, I had already a community on YouTube that was watching videos, and they were watching my first live streams, all of the live streams that I was doing, and I thought in the beginning. I tried for 1 week. I made some live streams only on Twitch without live streaming on YouTube, and many people couldn't come to Twitch because they had their own reasons, they couldn't watch. And somebody suggested to me to use a tool to do multi-stream at the same time, live stream on two or even more platforms, and this happened. I think it was in June of 2018, and since then I've been live streaming, at the same time, Twitch and YouTube. And now I think everybody's happy. Those who prefer watching from Twitch, they can watch from Twitch, and those who prefer watching from YouTube, they can watch from YouTube. I was thinking also to start live streaming on Mixer, but I don't think if it is a good idea. The concept of Diablo 4 seems to be kinda similar to Master Hunter. A hub where player can meet at go, where is it? At go to instances together or solo. Diablo 3 is offline on consoles. Yeah, on consoles, yes. This online playing has some good points in Batu. Imagine I'm playing Diablo 4 and then I'm seeing you playing with Lucas or Albati, but still I don't think playing online is good except expect crash. Που για θόντας, I'm not afraid, I'm not scared of crashes for Diablo 4, because when it comes to Blizzard, maybe sometimes they make some very bad decisions when it comes to game mechanics, but at least when it comes to the technical aspect of their games, I never had crashes with Blizzard games, online, offline, whatever. They have a very good team. They do great job with their technical stuff. I'm not afraid that Diablo 4 will... yes, we will have crashes as we have in Titan Quest, for example, or Grim Dawn, and we will have these problems. No, this will never happen. This has never happened in Diablo 3. It will never happen in Diablo 4. If Blizzard would make Diablo 1 remake in Diablo 3 game, Edge and I would spend a lot of time playing Diablo 1. Yes, Mockingbird. This is what makes me very sad. They took so much time and effort to create the invented Diablo 3 of Diablo 1, the Darkening of Tristram, and they didn't make it a game of its own. It is the same. This one could be a mini game inside Diablo 3. And people that haven't bought Diablo 3 because they are fans of Diablo 1 and 2, for example, they could buy Diablo 3 just to be able to play this mini game of Diablo Darkening of Tristram. I don't know, I guess. I don't know. Sometimes this company is very strange. And it is not hard for such a big company, it is not hard to create such a mini game in Diablo 3. With Diablo 3 game engine. It is the same. It is the same, Mockingbird, that we haven't gotten a Diablo 1 remake, not remastered, remake, because you know the game is very small as a game. It is not like other games, Diablo 2, which is huge, or Diablo 3, which is huge compared to Diablo 1, or Titan Quest, or I don't even know what else. It is a small game. Just imagine that in Diablo 1 you have only 100 unique items, not even 100, it is 97, I think. If you add the unique items of Hellfire Expansion, it goes up to 120, 127, something like that. Anyway, yeah, it is a small game, and it would be easy for them to, probably, to recreate this game. I mean, imagine with Diablo 1 remake with today's graphics, a new engine, game engine, or the game engine of Diablo 3, take the game engine of Diablo 3, use new textures, not the textures of Diablo 3, you know, textures that look more than like Diablo 1, and recreate the game. Why don't I have... Aman! I don't believe it. I totally forgot to activate the waypoint. Now if I go there, forget it. I will not. Yeah, I'm not going there. Fine arms, I had to turn in the jet figure in quest, but forget it. I'm not going there. Right now I'm not running back there. It is the same that we haven't gotten a Diablo 1 remake, or at least remaster. Good evening to you, Dracos. To be honest, I don't get it why they wouldn't wanna make Diablo 3, Diablo 4 playable offline. Lazar, probably because they want to avoid, because of piracy, you know, if they make Diablo games offline, they will have problems with piracy, and many people will start downloading the game from torrent sites, things like that, and Blizzard will lose money. This is the main reason, I think, why.
Fortune
favors the bold. Tuck, shoot. Zeus Vault Fire. Hello, Deus Vault. I think I started watching you about 2 or more years ago, and when I saw you playing, I asked you if I could join in the game, and I got surprised when you said yes. Why, Lalos, why was it this a surprise? Are you talking about Titan Quest multiplayer, Lalos? You just forgot a portal, yes, Puya. Hello, Osman! How are you today, Osman? Diablo 1 feeling atmosphere with a new tech graphics would be freaking awesome. Can you imagine? I mean, guys, come on! We are talking about Diablo 1. How can you not remake Diablo 1? Diablo 1... I mean, I would pay 60 euros for Diablo 1 remake with today's graphics and technology. Are you kidding me? If they could recreate the atmosphere of Diablo 1 with today's engine, it would be the best thing ever happened. Okay, the second best thing ever happened, because the best thing is Titan Quest. But anyway, let's not... Titan Quest will always be the best, so let's not make this comparison anymore. The warmth of life has entered my tomb. Prepare yourself, mortal! Mortadella! King Leoric, yeah. One thing that gives me hope to play it soon. Diablo 4 will be playable for PC, PS4 and Xbox One, so no next-gen consoles for now. But this detail doesn't give me hope for playing this game soon. Because, you know, Blizzard is trying to make great quality games, but at the same time they try to make games that will be accessible to as many people as possible. And they know that most people cannot buy super powerful PCs. And this is why they hold back a little bit when it comes to technology and how great graphics are of games. A little bit they hold back. For this reason alone. So, maybe this is not indicative of how soon the game will come out. Maybe it is, but maybe it is not, I don't know. I'm finally get cold and I have minus 50% cold resist right now. You are sick, flu? Oh! Is everything okay? Osman, I'm still not okay, I'm sick, but yeah, I think I escaped flu for now. My throat though is still burning, itching, scratching, you know, things like that. I have problems with asthma, I always have problems with asthma, almost always. But in general, I'm okay. Diablo 2 Remastered. Yeah, Minister, everybody watched Diablo 2 Remastered, I guess. I mean, until Diablo 4 comes out, something Diablo new would be nice. Diablo 1 atmosphere made the game awesome, creepy, but awesome, yeah. It make balance fixes to make more builds playable. Yes, yeah, I wouldn't say no to this thing. 50 FPS. Soon, 2 to 3 years. 3+, Albadi. I shall continue my zero death character. Wish me luck against the phone. Lalus, good luck against the phone, but be careful. What build do you play with? Hello, Chaosan. Okay, I have to be careful here because we have. Opa! I cannot leech life out of these enemies and they can destroy me. I don't want my daughter to die from these enemies. My daughter is dead. Diablo 2 Remaster is kinda difficult. Anything with 3D graphics would change its atmosphere completely. No, not 3D. Remastered doesn't mean that they will use 3D graphics. Remastered means that they will use maybe higher resolution techniques and use the same graphics, but a technique that would make these graphics look better. You should buy air purifier like HEPA filtered editions for asthma. Yeah, Osman, I don't know if this would help. I mean, 5 meters out of my house there is a park, there are trees, there is dust coming in the house all the time, and you cannot avoid all of these things. You go out of the house, you breathe in all of these things, and then everything starts working against you. But it is not a bad idea. That's why you like pod mod so much. Wait, what is Path of Diablo? Akarat, you mean Path of Diablo? I have 4 games I'd like to play right now, so I won't play any because I can't decide. Albadi, which games? Let me know which games and I will tell you what to play. If you cannot decide. In Battlefield 5 I surpassed my long range headshot. Aha, nice. I haven't played Battlefield games online for so long. It is sometimes I'm thinking about these games and but what can you do? You cannot play many games. Diviner. Oh, Divanier. I remember playing Diablo 1 back then and my sister was watching me playing. She was scared. I cannot life leech this enemy. This is why I'm getting killed. You missed. Wow! Oh, fucking wow! This has never... 12 years playing this game, I have never found this item so good rolled. With Hallowed of Fortitude. This has never happened before. And this is an item that you can get only from this boss. It is a monster boss. It is not Mastery Frequent. It is a monster item. This boss has both green items and Mastery Frequent items. Awesome! Wow! Such a great drop today. You are likely going to die before it comes out. Balance, I know. New game, Path of Grim of Diablo Dawn of the Exile. You also have a technique for killing that son of a daughter. Wow, the best item I have ever found from this boss. That was awesome, totally awesome. Skyrim BL3 Gothic 2 or NFSU 2. Wait, what is NFSU 2? Need for Speed... Need for Speed Ultimate 2? Or... I don't know what this means, NFSU 2. You get cause he's a ghost? Yeah, Lalouz, you cannot. Because he's a ghost or magical or something. He's something, I don't know what he is. But you cannot life leech this boss. So, I had a problem there. I survived, of course, but the first time I encountered this boss, I wasn't careful enough and I got killed. But anyway, the problem is that we cannot life leech these constructs as well. And, but these enemies are not hard. Ion. Worthless, sell it. No way, Albany. No way. Never. Never. Hello, Kowalski. Need for Speed Underground, not Ultimate. Okay. Need for Speed Underground 2. Warrior.
An ancient
evil. I don't care about ancient evils. Warrior. Underground 2, so tell me what should I play, or why is Mr. Fire? You should play the Outsider game. Play Titan Quest. Ha ha ha. Wait, should I sell something?
How could you pass up such a staff as this? Or have you seen the craftsmanship on this bracelet?
Yeah, now, look. This shield, Herculean Scatum of Immortality. This is an awesome shield. Maybe I should save this one, but... This is impenetrable Ichthyan Aegis. Or something like that. Anyway, I'm not. Bye! Amphitizen! Θα σε δω στο πλοίο, μη μου λες αντίο. Do you actually spend attribute points on health or is it worthless? Lazar, it is not worthless. Nothing is worthless in this game. But it depends. It all comes down to the build that you play with. Some builds require of you to spend points on health or energy or strength, intelligence, dexterity. It is not worthless. For this build, I don't spend any points on health. For other builds, yes. What I need right now is more offensive ability, so I'm going with dexterity. Wait, dexterity, maybe I should go with strength. No. Let's go with dexterity, to be able to hit enemies. I know my question might be silly, but I'm still a noob at Titan Quest. There is no silly question, Lazar, don't worry. All questions are good. If you say so, Mr. Fire, Miss Lalouz. Grey items are worthless in this game. Yeah, grey items are worthless, yeah. they could somehow turn make gray items good. What if they would bring a new feature to the game where we can upgrade the base damage of weapons or the base armor of armor items? And to do that, you pick up gray items. For example, if you want to increase the base damage of your weapon, you pick up a gray weapon, the same type of weapon. You go to the enchanter, you put the in the slot of the enchanter the gray weapon, you put your weapon that you want to upgrade, you pay some gold, and maybe pay use a crafting material, component and whatnot, and upgrade your base damage or your base armor. Why not? My assassin has something like over 3k OA, hitting crits every time, but he's not like a glass cannon, he's even worse. Even worse than glass cannon. Wow. How many deaths does it have? Mocking. How many deaths does your assassin have? Did you already have asthma when working out? Albadi, what do you mean? Ah, I guess you know what you mean. You mean that, yes, I was born with asthma. I have asthma since I was 0 years old. Let's go this way. Nice. Opa, a gin. One more gin. Hello, Radio Galaxia. Welcome to the Surprise Stream Radio. With the clay soldiers dead, everybody will die.
The sound of the blade when swung promotes harmony and long life. Luck.
Do you think that the devs of Titan Quest is going to focus on the current performance issues happening in the game in the future? I personally really hope so. Balance, I think they are already doing this thing. They are focusing on fixing bugs of the game and improving the game overall. And of course bringing the two expansions to consoles. This is what they are doing at this moment. And the next patch that we are waiting for will bring multiplayer fixes, improvements on multiplayer. We will see how good it will be, how good the fixes will be. Let's hope they will be awesome. They will improve the game significantly in multiplayer. Let's hope. Did it affect your workout? No, no, not really, Albadi, no. It didn't affect my workout. Of course, when we say workout, I was doing bodybuilding. I wasn't running or doing something like that, aerobics. And for what I was doing, it was okay. I didn't have any problems. Of course, I was getting problems, you know, from other sources, for other reasons. The usual reasons that give you problems with asthma. dust, pets and whatnot. But working out was not a problem. Zero problems while working out. A lot of deaths. It is level 85 blank character that I use for making builds.
Ah, okay.
Have you seen Diablo 4 Radio? Yes. Yes. How could I miss Diablo 4 Radio? Diablo 4. I'm waiting for Diablo 4 for about a decade now. I have made a couple of posts in my website as well, Action RPG website. So yeah, I know about Diablo 4. I watched the opening ceremony of BlizzCon. I saw everything. I have watched other streams and videos of Diablo 4 in general, the gameplay videos and whatnot. You know everything. And I feel like Diablo 4 can become a super great game. It can truly become a super great game and a true Diablo game. But they can always fuck it up. If that is so, there is no problem starting again, right? Albany, yeah. I don't think so. I'm not really sure because, you know, back then I was 30 years old, 22. I stopped bodybuilding about 18 years ago. Right now I'm 40. If I go now and start bodybuilding again, I don't know how my body will react, because at this point I can feel it. I'm very things have become very sensitive when it comes to asthma, because I get sick much easier. You know, the older you grow, the more sensitive your body becomes to things like that. But I'm not interested anymore to bodybuilding. If I go to the gym now, I would go to become a bodybuilder. I will go to lift weights, to fix my body a little bit, to have a good fitness. This is why I would go to the gym right now. I don't care about having big muscles anymore and all of these things. Radio, I'm okay. How are you? I'm a bit sick, but I'm okay. Grim Dawn coded update not released yet. Anybody knows when it will happen? Osman, today I was trying to visit the forums of Grim Dawn and see the Grim Misadventures, but the forums are not working. At least they were not working today, 3 or 4 hours ago, when I was trying to visit the forums. I don't know what is going on with Grim Dawn forums. You are waiting for 10 years? Well, you will wait for it for another 5. Not 5, 3. 3 years and 3 months. Diablo 4 will release 3 years and 3 months from today.
Once I was a powerful, having no need, freed, mystery and knowledge are born.
Have you a tan build? I have one and I don't like it because Storm is not that good for a warrior. Do you mean Thane build, Warfare and Storm Masteries, VW? I do have one. That build is awesome. I like it very much. It is called frozen blades. It is a thematic build. It is specifically made around Squall skill. So with frozen blades build, you can cast three squalls instead of one. But you know, you cast them one after another. You cast one now, and in the next second you cast another one, and in the next second you cast another one. This is the build, and it is awesome. It works very well. And it looks awesome as well. Hello, Nikki. Welcome, Nikki. Could you subscribe this channel immediately, Scooby? He's 60 years old and he's my hero since 2010. Osman, what is this? I wouldn't subscribe to a channel just to subscribe to a channel. If I don't like the content of the channel, why should I subscribe? And I don't even know this channel. I'm not saying that I don't like it, but I just don't know this channel. Does anyone know any good on-rail shooter for two-player on PC? Mocking Destiny 2, maybe? Would you be interested in Destiny 2 or something like that? I'm a spot buddy for a 63-year-old man who started with 55 or something for the first time. Aha! Nice. Diablo 2 Lord of Destruction looks more realistic than Diablo 3. Yes, it does. Osman, Diablo 4 already looks realistic. I don't know if you have seen, Osman, the trailer and the gameplay videos and streams of Diablo 4, but it looks much more realistic than Diablo 3. There is a big difference. And this is one of the main reasons why I think Diablo 4 can become a super great game. Because when it comes to the visual part, yes, Diablo 4 is a true Diablo game. It looks like Diablo now. It has nothing to do with Diablo 3 cartoony style. You create pristine plumage, plus 40 poison resistant, another plus 30 poison, good for Act 3. Yeah, Camille. Yes. This is awesome. You are from Poland. Okay, let's go this way. If we go this way, we will meet the dragon boss. And we want to meet the dragon boss. Destiny 2 is not an on-rail shooter. House of the Dead is a... This is what you mean, Mockingbird. House of the Dead was a great game back then. Popo... The memories. You don't have to subscribe. I said that because you will forget the channel. What I said, it could happen. Albadi, you got some dark chocolate. Why? I saw some of the gameplay, but I'm not sure when release we should check this out. Osman, it is very early, yeah. the game is in alpha version right now, and there will be many changes. Many changes will happen to the game. We will have to be patient and wait and see what happens. I hope for the best, and I'm optimistic at this point because it seems like Blizzard is going to pay attention to the feedback of the community, the players, and you know, all of these 7 years that of Diablo 3's lifetime, everybody was talking very bad about Diablo 3 because Diablo 3 is what it is. I mean about the style, the cartoony graphics of Diablo 3, the very broken mechanics, the RPG mechanics of Diablo 3 and all of these things that are very bad. And after so many years, Blizzard has learned their lesson, I guess, and hopefully they will fix things with Diablo 4. Fai, have you ever used any mods of Titan Quest? Tirkas. Yes, of course, yeah. I have Blue Estate, but I cannot fight House of the Dead legally. House of the Dead was an awesome game, but as a nerd, I prefer the Typing of the Dead. The Typing of the Dead? What is the Typing of the Dead? Undead. Nice. Because of Buy Me a Chocolate. Good evening to you, John S. Hello, Senilo Demenzi. Playing a Spellbinder 2 in Circle of Fire worth some points. Yes, it is, it is. I have 1 point only so far. 1 point, and I play Legendary. 1 point is enough. But it depends. It depends on your build, of course. For my build, 1 point is enough. But if you spend more points, if you can spend more points, it is better. Because, you know, mostly because of the recharge reduction, energy cost, and casting speed. If you don't need these three things, then 1 point is enough. By three they come, Avatarks. Yeah, by three they come. This is why I'm telling you guys that Diablo 4 will release in 3 years and 3 months from today. Because by three they come. Your daughter is not that weak for Legendary. Albadi, my daughter is very powerful for Legendary. But, you know, resistances are not very good. I mean, this is horrible poison. This is super bad. This is almost perfect. This is just okay. This is... It is positive. You can't say it is bad, but it is not good enough. This is okay. This is perfect. Pierce. But the build overall is very good. For what it is, this is an experimental build. I'm trying here to stack as many different types of damage as possible. For now, this build plays with at least 14 different types of damage. 14. And it does a pretty good job. It is, I could say it is a successful build. So far. Now, what will happen in the next act, which is Hades act, and that act is even more... it is scarier than Act 3. Who knows? You wouldn't say very powerful, but you get me. Yeah, yeah, I don't mean it is very, very powerful. I mean, you get what I mean. My 3.5k regen Templar has bad resistances, need to go down to 3k HP regen. Open the chest. What chest? Is there any chest there? I focus on strength, not on vitality. Yeah. Okay. Typing of the dead is house of the dead, but you type word phrases for shooting. What? You didn't open all three chests? Really? Hashtag Diablo 4. Why hashtag Diablo 4? Cup? Radio? What cup? What is a cup? Red beard. Ah, okay. You are talking to Red Beard. The Frostbite Shrine. Let's go this way, clear out this place. Okay, we have Yaoguai coming. Yaoguai is going to kick my ass very hard because Yaoguai deals a huge amount of fire damage. I'm going to get wrecked. And he also applies bleeding damage with his horns attack. So, I have to be super duper careful against that boss. Opa! I think Life Drain is the most powerful skill at this expansion. It is certainly a very, very good skill. The most powerful, I don't know. Don't forget to walk near the teleporter. Yes, Albadi, you are correct. Thanks for reminding me. I never forget to walk near this teleporter. This happened only with the teleporter of Great Wall. you know. Dun 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 dun. Bum, bum, bum. Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum.
Oh, very good. Come, stranger. We have some good things for you today.
Sell. 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 This is, should I keep it? Is not very good, but should I keep it? No.
Anytime.
Teleporter? Hello, Dave from the sleepy Canada. How is Canada doing, Dave? Have you gotten any snow? Dave. The only rival to that skill is probably the psionic beam. I don't know. Maybe Lalouse, I don't know. I haven't made any comparisons between these skills of Atlantis to see which one is the most powerful. But yes, Ionic Beam is super duper powerful. The good thing with Life Drain, this one, the Soul Drain, is... wait, are you talking about this one or this one? You said Life Drain. This is the Life Drain. I guess you are talking about the Soul Drain. So, yeah. It is an AoE skill and it can hit multiple enemies. So, but Psionic Beam is a straight line skill and it is not maybe as efficient as Soul Drain. Clear at cold, snow here none, but in the center they got very very early wet snow while trees still had leaves. Blocked roads, oh. Okay, so I guess winter is official coming, yeah. It is not really cold, at least down here the weather is not very cold. But you wouldn't say that it is something like very close to winter. It is autumn, but we are getting there. We are getting to Game of Thrones again. Ta-da-da. Oh. Maybe I should go and sell the defy to jewel wraps.
Come.
What did you say?
Farewell. Please. Goodbye. Yes, then. Goodbye. At your service. Anytime. Have a look. Farewell. Have a look. Anytime. At your service. Anytime. Come.
Life Drain with Addons. I have maxed out plus 4 skills on top and it just wrecks. Yeah. On top of that, the cooldown is very short. The only problems are device structures. Yep. Trees broken blocked the roads. Mid-October. Wow. Dave Rivers, life drain is a single target skill. The cascade is the add-on that makes this skill work also on multiple targets. And this new add-on from Atlantis expansion is an AoE skill. So you use this one on a single enemy, this one works on a single enemy still, but with the cascade active, it works also on more enemies at the same time. And with this one, it works in a big, a wide, we could say, radius of effect. It has a wide radius of effect. It is an AoE skill now. When did you go from Phaethodas to Mr. Fire? Potato, three weeks ago, I think. Hello, Wuzek. It is not a bad transition. You like it, Potato? Very nice, yeah. I also like it. Other people also like this transition. Maybe I should make some chocolate dollar bollar. What is chocolate bollar? You really got some chocolate. Albadi, if I could sell you chocolate, I would, but I cannot. Hey, don't kill me. Somebody has to destroy the big cats. Ow! Ah! That hurts! Chris Jennings, welcome to Mr. Fire. Thank you for subscribing, Chris Jennings. If we go to Mimir's Labyrinth or multiplayer, copy of us spawns only one or four players. One player only, Wuzek. Life drain got very exciting. Yeah, we could say that. Oh, nice. How dare you killing me?
Perhaps you can help me. For ages my ancestors have been... If you
chocolate balls pretty common in Sweden. Come to Papa Lalus. Come to Papa, eh? La, la. Come on, beast man, die please. After all, you will never survive. There is nothing here. That, wait, yeah, there is always nothing there. I predict Fire will fight Yao Guai in one go. Success is the prediction. Okay, thank you for believing in my daughter, Dave. Because, Dave, you know, this is my daughter build. This one makes so much noise. In Titan Quest and Grim Dawn, if I have all the expansions and my friend misses them. Chaosan, you can play with your friends if they don't have the expansions, but to play with them, they should make the game, they should host the multiplayer. If you host the multiplayer, they cannot join you because they don't have your expansions, but you can join their games even if they don't have the expansions. So, if you go to play with your friends and they don't have the expansions, tell them to host the game. They should be the hosts of the game. But yeah, the game looks awesome. I mean, let me show you. I am using everything. All of the stats settings are maxed out when it comes to graphics, all of them. And I'm also using the ambient occlusion. Now, if you activate this one, when you get very close to cave entrances, as you can see here, for example, I'm here. You cannot see my FPS. Yeah. Anyway, my FPS meters down here, it says 5960 FPS. 60 FPS here. When I go very close to cave entrances, it goes down. It goes down to 35 to 88 FPS. This happens because we have active this HBAO. If I put it to off, this doesn't happen. This is a bug that has been happening since Atlantis came out, since day one, with HBAO. I don't know why. It is something because of the game engine is very old. It is anyway. But the game looks awesome. By having all of the settings maxed out and active, the game looks awesome. What items are the people in chat searching for in Titan Quest? I don't know. Hello, Elven at Heart. I believe in fire too, but with this hero, all it would take is a sneeze of elemental damage and he is dead. Lalus, not only elemental, but you know, poison and bleeding as well. I know you don't want us to give you rare items, but at least one item per person for your birthday should be okay, no? Albadi, yeah, okay, I don't say, I would get to three items per person for my collection. Not for the community build, because for the community build, yeah, but for the community build, I take as many items as you want. But it is good only to get super rare and super powerful items for the community build, because we cannot have 1000 items in the community build. The space of the storage and inventory of that build is not that big. Poison and bleeding. Lalus, no, you are not mistaken about elemental damage, because fire damage is elemental. And I have only 30% fire resistance. And Yaoguai boss, which is coming up very soon, deals lots of fire damage. And I have to be super careful, because if I get hit with the fiery attack of Yaoguai, I am almost dead. Almost. I'm not saying that I will die absolutely die, but I will get very close to dying. And this is going to be a problem. My first legendary for today. Let me see. Yeah. The first legendary I fought today, Sacrum of the Sun. I will keep it for my collection of items because I'm recreating the collection since I lost my collection. So I will keep it. It is a good drop though. Yeah. Your birthday is soon, Fai. Elven, my birthday is next Wednesday, I think. Yeah. 13th day of November is next Wednesday. Hello, Goldinger. Now I said one. Jokes aside, I made items for yourself since your vault is kinda empty. Yeah, buddy, I will accept 3 items per person for my collection. Lalouz, you almost died. But you didn't die, right? Captain, enjoy your dinner. Man, I'm dead. Let me hit you. Yeah. Maiden's Kiss, Rocks. I will save this one because I have it already in my collection. I have the full Rock set. This set, the epic set of Rocks cover. I have it already in my collection, so I will sell it to make some gold. Wait, what? Happy birthday in advance. Thank you, Elven. Thanks. Those cursed mage... Lalouz, did you get killed by mage dragonians? Will you play Gothic 3 again this week, maybe? Goldinger, absolutely. Yes, I will. I downloaded Gothic 3 again today. Because, you know, these days I made... I reformated my PC. And... I had to install everything from the beginning, and I installed today Gothic 3. I don't know when, but maybe this week. I don't know. We will see. Now you want to play Titan Quest. Albadi, why? I have Marduk's Tablet of Destiny, Death Ward, those... Ah, okay. You survived, Lalouz. Very nice. It will be a very, very nasty thing to get killed now at this point. You have reached the legendary Act 4 almost. And getting killed right now is... it is very bad. May fortune bring you more life. What is your favorite secret character? Mr. Klakos, do you mean Secret One? The game Secret One character? I think it is the Gladiator. I have played Gladiator, I have played Dwarf, I have played... I don't remember the other classes actually. There is an Elf. Whoa. So, but yeah, don't forget guys, now we have the Action RPG Sundays thematic live streams, which means every Sunday we will be playing live streaming a different Action RPG game, old games and also new games sometimes. We are going to try and cover the whole action RPG genre on live streams. And maybe some Sundays we will have videos for this series of action RPG Sundays. Yeah, so we will also play sacred games as well. Hello to you, Zalfex SRB. Welcome to the stream, Zalfex. Keep it for me, please. Lalus, what do you want me to keep for you? Ah, the Rogue's Harness. I have to remember to keep it for you, Lalus. I have to go to my stas. Yeah, okay. I will keep it for you, Lalus. This stream is extra or you will not do one of the upcoming... Chaos Sun, today's stream is a surprise stream, which means it is an extra stream. I will be here tomorrow, at the day after tomorrow, as the schedule suggests. And unless I become more sick than what I am right now, I don't think so, but you never know. Flu is very strange. Sometimes it is very strange. And who knows? Maybe I will surprise you with one more stream this Thursday. You start from beginning with Gothic, or did you keep your save game? I have kept my save game, Goldigger. I will continue with the same character. To farm good items for you, I still have to complete my elemental dual wield build in Gothic 3 too. Elemental dual wield build? You love playing the combat wizard. Mr. Klakos in Gothic 3 combat wizard. You are welcome, Lalus. Opa, not damage reflection. But for the month of November and December, I have a new goal. My new goal is to try and do as many live streams as possible. So expect more surprising live streams. And at the same time, I have to work on many videos because, as I said, I have about 5-6 new builds to show you. Including this one, of course, my daughter build. So yeah, I have too many things to be doing. Dun, dun, dun. Dun, 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 dun. I'm also going to be playing Diablo 3 more, especially when the new season starts. I will be live streaming Diablo 3. Or at least I want to do this thing. I want to play the new season because it brings some new items and interesting things to the game, interesting items. And maybe we can figure out some nice builds, fun builds, not meta builds. I don't care about meta. In Diablo 3, meta is broken. We will see what happens. Nobody knows what happens in the future. I'm on vacation in December. Albadi, the whole December. Wow, you are very lucky, Albadi. Vacation the whole month of December. Why am I getting killed now? Resisted Crown of Stability. Useless. Sell it. Da-da-da.
can.
When is Diablo 3 new season? Dave, they haven't said yet when the new season starts. They have said that the current season 18 will end at November 10th, 6 days from today. Ah, this Sunday. But they haven't said when it will start. I guess it will start before the end of November. Let's hope it will start soon enough. Μαχόγκανη, μαχόγκανη, καρδιά μου. Εσύ που γκρέμισες τα όνειρά μου. Water. No, only 3 weeks. Albany, 3 weeks vacation is good enough. I mean, come on. The month has 4 weeks and a couple of days. And you get 3 weeks month December, in December. Especially December, 3 weeks vacations, awesome. This is totally awesome. Bam, bam, bam. What is that? You saw with November, I heard December for the Diablo 3 season. No, Gold Digger, I'm not sure about November, I'm just saying. I'm saying that maybe, I don't know. But where did you hear about December? I said Cursed Mage Dragonians and the game throws at me to Hero Mage Dragonians. You should be careful what you say about Dragonians, Lalos. Don't say things like that. Season 18 ends on November 18th. Not 10th, 18th. I thought it was 10th. Why 18th? So next season should come with patch 267, which will be before December, I think. I don't know. From some Diablo 2 players. Diablo 2 players. Why not Diablo 3 players? I mean, we are talking about Diablo 3 season here, not Diablo 2. How much is this game? I don't know. Titan Quest. Are you asking about Titan Quest? AIM. Titan Quest was on sale currently. I don't know if it is still on sale or not. But I don't know the price of the game right now. You're playing Diablo 2 at the moment. I love Mage Dragonians. I hope I see them all the time. Reverse psychology.
Yeah.
You should tell that to the game, Lalouche. Let the game know your wishes. Typo, yes, November 10th. Okay, November 10th. I knew about November 10th, not 18th. So, it makes sense that the new season will start before the end of November. I mean, if they start the new season 20, at least 20 days after the current season ends, then many people will start complaining. This item is useless. And I don't know if this will happen. We will see. By the way, if I am exactly where you are and I am going to wait for you to kill the boss. Nice. And from what I heard, the barb got nerfed. I don't know, Albadi, I didn't hear anything about the barb. Let me see. Crashing Vortex. Ah! Elemental Shielding. Okay. Okay, so here is what we will do. If I get killed once from this boss right now, I will delete my channel. I will use the elemental shielding scroll. Let's go. Okay, guys, everybody, thanks for being here for so long, but now I have to delete my channel. This is it. I'm out of here. My content creation, live streaming at YouTube career ends right here, right now. I have to delete my channel now, and this is it. You will never see me again. I will never see you again. This is the end of our story. Can you just describe what happened? Right now, the unthinkable happened. This is what happened. This thing killed me. Bleeding resistance. I wasn't fast enough to click my health potion. Ah, I'm getting wrecked by a Red Bull. It didn't happen. Revive him with chocolatey goodness. Goodness. I was hoping for moral uplifting if you killed it in one go, but now I'm not sure if I should fight. Lalouz, Lalouz, you need bleeding and fire resistances. Red Bull gives you wings. Yeah, wings to go to heaven after you get killed. I have to be more careful. Come on. Σούρουφ του πα... Is your daughter's name Europa? No, my daughter's name is my daughter. Why, Albadi, should it be Europa? He almost killed you, now you are scared. Lalouz, how much fire and building resistance do you have? Not again. What? Always. Oh, actually, I kill myself because I'm using this attack when I shouldn't be using it. I'm killing myself all the time against this boss. Come on, I'm doing stupid things. Blah, blah, blah. Where is my water? This is not happening. 80 bleed at 46 fire. You need Lalouz. Go and buy a scroll of elemental shielding. Okay, right now I will use the scroll of elemental shielding because it will protect me against fire, but I'm still having problems if I'm not careful enough against his bleeding attack. Oh! He has his full amount of health back. Come on, boss. Come on, come on. Yes. Okay, now you die, please. No! What's to the... I I could have killed this boss without dying, but I was doing stupid things again. Anyway. Why? At least I found this item for my collection of items, which is very good. This is a great shield. It is no fun if I tell you why. Okay, Albad. If you don't want to tell me why, don't tell me why. I think that's not the problem. I have very low defense ability and armor.
Worthy trap.
Any tips for Warden? I played till level 32 at end boss now, but he is hard as fuck to kill. For Warden, you want to spend your attribute points on strength and dexterity. I don't know how you play your Warden with a shield and a spear, for example. Do you play with a shield and a sword or a club weapon? How do you play? It is better to play with a spear, because you know, spear gets some very good buffs from Haddock Mastery. And it helps very much. I just view Yenis Hiton from a bone pile, farming for Minoans from Butter Cuffs. Nice. Yenis Hiton is nice. Dave, Yenis Hiton provides also about 10% physical resistance, if I remember correctly. Shield and the spear, yeah. So, shield and the spear, you want to put your attribute points on strength and dexterity. You want to fight items, armor items based on strength to get the best base armor possible. You want to fight green items with many stats, good stats for your character. You want many resistances. Now, you say against the boss. What boss? Ed boss? Do you mean Typhon? Typhon on only boss? That boss? For that boss, you need life leech resistance, vitality resistance, of course, some elemental resistance. You also need to use the, you know, the shrines around the boss in that place. And it is good for you to buy some scrolls and use scrolls against that boss. 17% physical resistance on this one. Wow. 17, not 10%. Hello, Ilya Davidov. Welcome. Typhon. Yeah, Typhon.
Typhon.
Also, don't forget, Florence. When Typhon uses a skill, a spell, and he gets his thorns out, he has his thorns out, you can see his thorns on his body. When you see thorns, you do not attack. Do not attack with spells or with attacks. Do not attack at all. Wait for his thorns to wear off and then you attack again. Because when he has his thorns out, he deals damage retaliation and some damage reflection. Which means when you hit him with attacks and spells, you get back damage. And this one can kill you as well. Yeah, scrolls help. Scrolls always help. How is the build? The concept of it looks hard as fuck. The build is good. It is very good. We play legendary. I have died sometimes, 25, but you know, I died mostly because I'm not very careful against some bosses or enemies. Okay. Oops, excuse me. Okay, I don't have the best resistance as possible, as we can see. But the build plays very well. It does good. For what it is very good. Hello again, Captain. I kite around to charge that kite again, but he sucks health so much, should probably look at life leech resist. Yeah, Florence. You need, if you can fight somehow by a trade, maybe, the legendary ring, Bud of Souls, this one alone provides around 90 to 100% life leech resistance. You need life leech resistance and some vitality resistance. He has so many HP. About HP, you have to be patient. To hit the boss and kill it. Da-da-da-da. He is 32. But it is okay. I mean, 32 or 33, 44, it is okay. The level is okay. You don't need more than 32 to be defeat Typhon. It is all about your items and what skills you use at that point. And if you use scrolls, if you use the shrines around Typhon, how you play, when you attack, when you do not attack, if you have life leech resistance, you know, all of these things, or energy leech resistance. You talked about the Bud of Souls, yes. Albadi, yeah. It seems that I missed a good boss fight. Captain, I got wrecked by that boss. That boss fight was a nightmare. I wasn't very careful, I was doing stupid things. and I got killed. You see, when I don't try to play hardcore, I do stupid things. When I play hardcore, I don't get killed. It is all about psychology.
You can't hold anymore.
But now I can hold anymore. Raptor tooth. Bone pile. Pam param. Come on, bone pile, give me something good, bone pile. I beg of you, give me something good, bone pile. Dun, 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 dun. Which boss? Yaoguai boss. That's what I'm saying, a good boss fight. Your build is too weak, admitted boy. I'm not a boy, I am my daughter. I am a lady. A young lady killing monsters. Come on. That's a replay I'll have to watch, and I guess it would make a funny video, Mr. Fai's humoristic style. Who is Mr. Fai?
You can't carry anymore.
What did you say?
You can't carry anymore.
How dare you? What? Ah, okay. See, yeah, okay. Bam, bam, bam. Bam, 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 bam. Bam, 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 bam. Bam, 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 bam. Nothing. Suck. Do you have a mod to loot money, or how you are you so fast? I don't play mods, no. In Anniversary Edition, you go to Options menu, Key Binding, You scroll down here, it says, where is it? Quick pickup. You assign a hotkey here on a quick pickup. Assign a hotkey, and when you click the hotkey, you pick up all of the gold, potions, charms and relics that are in close proximity, you know, within the radius of the quick pickup ability. Bertalan Balog, thanks for subscribing, welcome. Okay, let's see what this guy is doing. No! Damage reflection! Come on, dude! Damage reflection, you coward! You always use damage reflection. Okay, I will use my scroll now, so go to hell. No! Yes! Ah, I survived! This one was using damage reflection, this is why I almost got killed.
Oh, I have never been so I will expect for hundreds of
I allow you to leave this one on the ground, it's not a good one.
Peace and safety. What will I do now?
The saber tooth.
I must go to the city or learn the way of the warrior.
Lalouche! Well done! You killed the bull! Very nice! I hope without getting killed, right? I played that Frostburn Tigerman yesterday in Hardcore twice and got so scared. But Krugs, did you survive? Or did he kill you? Come on. I was referring to the Kraken's Fists type of video. But it is right to say that video has nothing to do with Mr. Fire. Yeah. Okay. Today I die stupid deaths.
Oh, stranger. When
yeah, stranger, Robasil. Of course, if I die, I will delete this character. Well, Lalouche, if you play hardcore, yeah, you should do that. That wasn't Greek. I don't even know what that was. I'm still at zero deaths and just got to legendary difficulty. Very nice. Good. Come Crackseth, what build are you playing with? Hardcore. Why don't you open your window so we can have a look at Jupiter? I don't think you can see Jupiter from my windows. All that you will see is darkness, nothing else. Para-pa-pam-pam. Para-pa-pam. Damn. Beastman down. Come on, big boys with the big spears. Come on, hit me, please. Yes, good boys, this is it. Come on, hit me more, please. Come on, show me your spear. Do you have a very long spear? Are you Leonidas or a Spartan? Nope, you are not. If you are not, then you are fucked. Come on, hit me with your spears and swords. You don't have swords, not even spears. You have bows, but your bows are useless. Yeah, you are dead now. What planet are you from then? I'm not from a planet. I am from a star, Albadi. Darkness. Is that your new seeker build? No. Playing trickster poison build with two Gorgon edges and some poison scaling. Yeah, Gorgon says is super duper powerful for poison builds. You have a very powerful build, Krax. Very nice. I still haven't played any builds with the Gorgon Sheds. And I will, in the future I will. I don't know when, but I will. Bam, bam, bam. Trying to see Jupiter, you just get more stupider. Nice. Greek. Yes. Unfortunately, yes, Greek Ivanov. Bam, 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 param. Bam, 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 param, bam, bam.
This door is locked.
This door is locked once again. Bugs, 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 bunny. My Britney Spears build is super fun to play. Do you have a Britney Spears build, buddy? Studio, hello. Studio, how is Cassandra doing? Or maybe she's not doing
Isn't
at all.
This a beauty of a robe?
I don't know. Stated Mongolian helm. Sell it. Resist the crowd stability. Sell it. Sabertooth. Sell it. Hail. Hail traveler. Dun, dun, dun. This one is for Lalus, I think. Right, Lalus, I think you are the one who asked for this item. And I have Gorgon Sheds. Up to 1161 poison damage over 3 seconds. Super powerful. Ion, I will keep it for my collection, the new collection of items. Okay, I will not sell this one. I will not sell this one. I keep it for the collection. The same here. The same here. This is a very nice Ichthyan Wumber. Vitality damage, lightning damage, and more lightning damage buffs. Legendary tier. Very nice item. If you want to play with intelligence-based build melee with this item is splendid. Because it gives you lightning damage with elemental with intelligence builds is awesome. Imagine you forgetting to get the Sangan teleporter. I don't think this would happen, Albadi. This would never happen. You got the armor, Lalus, okay. Is there any Greek dub available? What do you mean, Greek dub? Greek dub? Dub? What dub? She's doing fine. She still is the beautifulest, beautiful beauty of your life. The beautifulest. Dun, dun, dun. The ritual talisman. Frenzy. This is poison resistance, elemental resistance, lethal strike. It is not for my build because I'm playing a very specific build. It is a great item, 20% reduced damage for 3 seconds on enemies that you hit with this sword or dagger, whatever it is, but for this build is not good. The golden shield of Pelaron. Nah.
Bye now.
Bye bye. Bye bye. Can somebody explain what's the point of Trickster? I honestly don't see it. She's rogue is for blood, pierce and poison, drone is for mostly melee mage gameplay. It doesn't really matter. I mean, Davidoff, you can use Rune Mastery as a secondary mastery. I mean, you can use some skills of this mastery to help you perform better with your thrown weapons, Gorgon Sage, or whatever you are using. You know, you can cast in front of your enemies from a distance. The wall of Menhir, and from a distance the enemies cannot pass through the wall, they hit the wall, and from a distance by with safety you attack with your thrown weapons the enemies from a distance, again from a distance, and from a distance you kill your enemies easier this way, from a distance. So use it as a secondary mastery. There is probably something you don't see in it. Hello, Michelle Van Zin. Good, Michelle, how are you doing? We are okay.
The forest of the ancients lies to the east. Go ahead.
Go ahead, open the gate, you idiot. Okay, I will open the gate, me idiot. Dun, dun.
I'm going to ask to get re- See, I told you. See, I told you. See, I told you it was. See, I told you. See, I told you. See, I told you it was bad.
See, I told you.
Hello, the cellist. Man, man. Maman. Hello, Maman. Who is Maman, the cellist? The wall is a good solution. I just noticed that Seal of Fate is also good since it's upgraded this around. Yeah. Which must be amplified by passives. Yeah. Yeah, this is true, Davidov. Also, the Seal of Fate, the add-on of Seal of Fate reduces resistance of enemies. If you hit with that add-on the enemies, they get their resistance is reduced and now your bleeding damage attacks deal even more bleeding damage. Don't forget it. My man, I wanted to say. Ah, okay, Jonathan. My man, not my man. Okay, that was a typo. Typo. Forest of the Ancients. Typo. Popo. Para pa pa para pa. Have you seen such an item before? Vatrahos breastplate with the Mountaineer's prefix. I mean, this item is very rare and very powerful. 111% pierce resistance. And this item, right now I'm using this item in this build because of the pierce resistance that I get. My pierce resistance is perfect, 80%. It doesn't go higher. And I have this perfect resistance because of this 111% pierce resistance. This is an awesome item. It is very rare to get this item, and it is very awesome. You are welcome, Davidov. Also, Davidov, don't forget, when you use the rune weapon skill of Rune Mastery, this one, every time you use it, it charges up and it increases the total damage and the elemental damage that you deal. Total damage means that you also now apply more bleeding damage as well. This is what it means. So, don't forget these details. This is why I say Rune Mastery is a very well thought mastery, because it can help all other masteries. You can make many, many different builds with Rune Mastery. Greens are overrated. Wild, buddy. Why would you say such a bad thing about greens, Albuddy? But we talk about Trickster, own weapon is it used to do to calculate? You play with calculated strike. Okay, maybe you could be using it as well. I mean, have you tried to play Trickster with rune weapon instead of calculated strike to see what you can do? Maybe it works better. Have you made any tests? Maybe it can help you better, who knows? Tell that to Tinkerer items. Yeah, exactly. Dun, 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 dun. You ain't no pimp if you are equipped 8 purple. This is why you don't like green items. I mean, take a look at this splendid item, Unholy Talisman of the Tinkerer. Energy drain, more vitality damage from the item, Unholy prefix, and also the Tinkerer, I have two components of this item. Star of the Evening and Monkey King's Trickery. This is awesome. This item is pure perfection. This item is pure perfection. We should take a screenshot and put this item to the Museum of Pure Perfections. I just got a super, super awesome idea. I will create a museum of super rare items of Titan Quest. Ha! Super awesome idea! I will create a museum of super rare items of Titan Quest. You know, photographs with stats and the items themselves. Wow! You are jealous of this amulet, Captain? Me too, yeah. Fire streaming, my studies are fucked up. Cassandra is beautiful. The only mistake here is the Malacca Greek. Oh my god, if I had this item in my character right now. This item is pure perfection. And I would say that this item is not pure perfection, but it is very close to being perfect. because of the stats. At how rare it is. It is very rare. No need to thank me for that fire. Albadi for the turtle. I don't understand the turtle. What is the turtle, Albadi? Here we have the another tinkerer item. Electrical burn damage, frost burn damage, cold damage buffs, vitality damage resistances. Here we have a very nice, super nice and powerful item with very nice components. I mean, this build is awesome. Yes, it is not the most powerful build out there, of course, and it is not the best build for survivability, but I love it. It is awesome. Dun, dun, dun. What is the name of the breastplate? Vatrachos. Vatrachos breastplate. This one drops only from frog enemies of Act 4. Frog enemies. Vatrachos breastplate. The item itself is rare without added affixes, but getting this item with the prefix Mountaineers, which is this one, it is even more rare. I don't think this item looks like Cassandra. No, it doesn't. The only advantage I see in rune weapon for trickster is bonus to total damage and lifesteal. Yeah, this is it, Davidov, yeah. What is the name of the breastplate? From which enemies does it... From frog enemies, Act 4, Hades, Act. Turtle is green and lame like those items. You don't like turtles overall, Albadi. It also has a suffix. The suffix? What suffix? The pierce resistance... Ah! Yeah, the pierce resistance, I think, because Vatrachos comes initially with pierce resistance, as far as I remember, but not this number of pierce resistance. It should be... It is Mountaineers. Vatrachos breastplate of something that gives pierce resistance, and I don't remember. Something like that. Yet you say it's perfection? Yes, studio. No, no, not this one. Not this one. This one is pure perfection. This one. The artifact gives what ability? 25% chance of plus 200% elemental damages. 50% weapon-based damage becomes elemental. Recharge reduction to all skills in room master, which is useless. And also strength, which I need. Slowed attack retaliation. No, I think this comes with the Mountaineers prefix, if I'm not mistaken. The slowed attack retaliation. Cold resistance, reduced freeze duration, physical damage, health regen, and the projectiles avoid. And also slowed attack retaliation, I think, comes with the prefix of Mountaineers. But I'm not sure, I don't really remember. I had a turtle for 2 months when I was a child. Did you watch Green Hell game? Yes, Jonat, I did. The game looks like a survival game with very good graphics, though, and yeah. I have reached you. Lalos, you have reached my rebirth founder, this place. Dun, dun, dun. So, everybody, I stop here for tonight. This was one of the many surprise extra live streams that I'm going to be doing from here on for the next 2 months. I will try to do as many live streams as possible, and I also have many, many videos to break this 2 months, so I have lots of work to be doing. As long as I am okay, I'm not sick, because these days I'm a bit sick. One of the best artifacts, I used it on my Golden Boy Elemental build. This artifact is very powerful. I mean, 25% chance of plus 200% elemental damage. This is super powerful as a stat. So, tomorrow I will come back to do another live stream, of course, because tomorrow is Tuesday, and Tuesday and Wednesday is my normal live stream days. Tomorrow I will live stream probably Titan Quest, maybe Hardcore again. We will see, I'm not sure. We will see. Maybe I will live stream Gothic 3 tomorrow, or maybe Titan Quest. Or maybe. I don't know. But yeah, probably one of these two games. We will see. Captain, you are welcome. Have a good night, son. May the fates be on your side. Here studio, thank you. Everybody, thanks for watching again and also chatting. Thanks again very much to the new followers, subscribers, and also Laluz for becoming a member and for your support. I really appreciate your support, guys. And tomorrow I'll be here again, hopefully. Thank you, but goodbye, Elbuddy. Okay, Elbuddy. You have matters to attend to, Elbuddy. Today is a good day for me. BF5, I played one match and got it in 10 minutes, two headshots. At 750 meters. Nice. Good night to you, Chaosan. Hard decision, Gothic or Titan Quest. Maybe I will play Gothic tomorrow and Titan Quest the day after tomorrow. Or Titan Quest tomorrow and Gothic the day after tomorrow. Or maybe I will get another idea to play something else. Totally something else. I don't know. We will see. Dark Oris, have a good one, Dark Oris. Okay, I will see you tomorrow, everybody, have a good one.